Our completed project file in this video series uses CSS media queries. To observe those CSS media queries in action, we are going to use web browser responsive design tools. This is our completed file, and we are viewing it in Firefox. And we want to see it in different response view layouts. So we always could resize the web browser and see the impact of what would happen to our page when the viewport is resized. And we can see also the effect of using media queries to change what the web page looks like depending on the widths. But we also have tools that we can install. We're going to use Chris Petterick's Web Developer Tools. And when you install that, you get a toolbar. And on the toolbar, we have a choice called Resize. It has a few choices for you to resize your actual web browser, which you may want when you're trying to target a desktop or a laptop view. When we want to look at the various responsive layouts, there's a menu choice at the bottom that does this very nicely for us. If we choose that, it will open up another tab window and gives us a menu bar with choices on. I'm going to choose the Collapse All choice. And we can see the presets that are installed already, and we could choose those presets, update them, add to them, and change them to whatever we like. So let's take a look at the first one. The first one is probably the width of an iPhone, typically 320 wide, and we can see the layout of our web page in that view. And if we go back to the original tab, you can see this is the same page, just now being presented in the web browser as if the web browser was only 320 wide. And then we can also look at a landscape version of that. And you can see it scrolls just as if it was running inside of a device or a viewport of that size. And we have some other presets. There's a small tablet. And we're really seeing the same page. So far, we're just seeing a flexible design. When we go to the small tablet landscape, we're actually going to an 800 width versus a 600 width in the last view. And in this case, what's happening is the colors being changed and the font sizes are being made larger. If you look here at the top and at the bottom, you can see the differences. So this helps us see if we're actually detecting the width and making the changes we'd like. Here's more of an iPad type of width. And that's in portrait mode. And there's no real change here, so actually our breakpoint for this particular layout and color and style is at least 768. And then down here we have a landscape view, and we are now detecting 1024 width, and we have changed again the background color and the font sizes. And then lastly we have a desktop laptop layout, and we bring this up. And the real item to notice here is that if we go back to just a web browser view, you'll see the web browser fills the entire page because it is the viewport. When we come back to the responsive layout here, we actually see that it shows that this is the actual end of the viewport. And so that's the actual 1920 width. Also, you notice that in our styling, once we get to this particular breakpoint, we're no longer allowing the text to expand continuously, so there is some max width set on one of the containers that's holding these text in. So we'll take a look at that as we get into the actual work. Firefox also has a built-in capability to look at responsive design views, and it's part of the web developer tools. If we go up to the menu in Firefox, Tools, and then Web Developer, you will see that there is a responsive design view. So we'll choose that. And that gives us a little different way of handling the design views. And actually, it came up with the last view we had, which was arbitrarily at 117 pixels wide. And we can actually use the handles, and you can watch those numbers change up there, and you can see the actual breakpoint when we hit one of them. So right around 1024, you could see there's some change going on. And it's kind of handy to have when you're trying to test for a particular media query. You'll see there's different ways of doing them. And if you really need a way to fine-tune it, make sure it's working, it's a debugging technique. They also have presets, so we can look at the traditional iPhone view. And we can also see that in landscape mode or portrait mode. There's a rotate button. or you might want to look at this in the traditional iPad width on a portrait, landscape. And just note, we're just changing a few minor styling items so we can actually see that we've detected different widths. And here we have a desktop or a laptop view. And you can see the actual width of the text is being stopped at this point, no matter how wide your browser gets. And then what we'll do is we'll actually resize down. And you can see in between the breakpoints, we're just using a flexible layout at this point. Very simple, single column layout. And you'll notice that we have some styling that's below a 320 breakpoint. Actually, we hit 320. When we hit that 320 width, that is our actual first mobile design. So mobile first means what we'll do is design for the smallest view that we're targeting. So we're targeting for 320. Below that, we're just seeing the base styling. If you have a narrower width to design for, then you'll need a breakpoint for it. So you really don't look at this as actually a target width, but if there is a device that's smaller width, this is what they will see. So you have to decide how many breakpoints and also perhaps what your base styling might look like in case of someone seeing it outside of the choice that you made for your first target. And there's our first target, and then as we keep growing, you can see the width targets. Now, it keeps telling you it's custom up here because as we drag these handles, we're changing away from the actual presets of the devices. But we can always go back to those as we need them. Responsive design testing tools are available across web browsers. New tools appear regularly and they are continuously updated. Keep in mind that high-profile web properties test designs on the actual targeted devices. They may use service companies or build internal test laboratories, but that does involve an investment. The tools available in web browsers are your next best alternative. And they may be all you need for building, testing, and deploying your responsive web designs.